that stunner.
Smooth operator.
Yes, if you somehow aren't sick of us after 8 hours
of us. I'm sick of us,
well, I'm sick of us too. Not only 8 hours of us yesterday, you've got another 8 hours of us today. I apologize if we become as obnoxious as we and our worst insecurities feed into our first round of Counter-Strike. We have got Hampus, and he's into the top site without a touch of contact.
Guys,
he's just called top site clear.
Hey guys, there's nobody in A.
Yeah, well, Apex is gonna have something to say about that. The bomb, three headshots, catches Linus as well, anticipating a third. Yeah, Hampus, the unknown entity, reveals himself, and event's not broken. Kyoji's already taken down Devir, and I suspect there's not much more to be said. Three to hunt him down.
But if anything here, because going into this major, I think Na'Vi are the favourites for most. These two are, well, timing their peaks quite nicely here. Younger blood, big signings, some huge names. Carrying their regions on their back. France and Sweden alike here. And while Hampus' scout will tag onto Apex, that nade is well timed onto two. With the ramp control right now, NIP, if they do turn their attention towards this help position, Apex was tagged up by Hampus' scout, 30 HP, and he could just be blown on over. But Saibu's crept up secret, and Hampus is dead.
Yeah, it doesn't get easier than that for Saibu. Just clicks on the head, Hampus gone.
Smart from Apex here. You see the way that he's passively tucked in this awkward angle to clear, letting his teammates deal with it while they try and search for an easy kill. So just by staying alive, he's on the ramp.
And this is twice it's looked like NIP have got mandatory slash exciting territory, and they're not been able to do anything with it. It's like Vitality will let them in, but it's all intentional.
What does it go? Giving them enough rope to hang themselves.
That's
here.
The one, yeah, precisely. They just adjust their setup, and this is clean. Unlikely to see a plant now, yeah. Rez caught fumbling with his smokes, and that'll be scooped up by Zywu for good measure. 2-0, Vitality get off to that CT start.
Yeah, should be the eco now with just a light upgrade or two here coming in from NIP. But I was impressed with Apex's movements after that tag and also the teammates taking the space and punishing NIP right there. Zywu and Shox getting big thumbs up. It's good to see NIP locking themselves in for that legend status, especially with the major being on home soil. That's going to be great for a lot of the fans, right? They're only going to be three matches away in that second round of Swiss from being on that stage. So really, really cool stuff. And so many younger names than that to see on that stage as well. So it's going to be quite the experience for everybody here as we get to celebrate our lovely game. But here we are again, back towards Yard, and multiple rifles peering in their direction. Zywu up from the heaven chimes on in with Apex, and the combo now being more than established here.
Yeah, I think they've got a very good idea. Not only the straight bullet out of Rez's dig, but good nade onto the nose of Hampus. Should very well have this one set. For success, more chip damage converted. We can see Plopsky down to 80. And I don't think they're going to leave Yard, Chad.
Nah, so why would you?
Ready to have a biff. Sticking around, hoping their deegs will connect. There's only two in play, and make that one.
It's a bit of an uneven aim map right now, isn't it? Right, we spawn with the rifles. You guys here can just try your luck on these pistols without anything behind it. But one after the other, they're going to fall like flies.
Any more of that? Any more? The answer is no. A 3-0 start.
How long can they extend that bonus round and a half here? Due to the lack of casualties, MP9 for Kyojin Zai was still with that Famous. And towards Yard, we turn our attention again. This time, with a smoke wall being deployed. Deep nade onto device. Just going to chip him away here to 82. And, well, here's the big man himself. Zai, we're about to come up secret and chime in with Apex again to stall this out.
Ooh, and aggressively fighting. Yeah, Blobsky does manage to keep things even.
They will get across, or at least they should.
It's unlikely there's a T-Orb in play so early, especially with Device now down and out caught early. So they can be a bit more aggressive on some of these engagements. Rez has been cut down to size.
Oh, look at Apex.
Yeah, he has taken some risks, and it's been rewarded. Both Shox and Apex will connect into those Yard aggress, and, well, NIP left with very little. What can they count on? So they'll park Linus red. I suspect he'll be the last to take some contact. He might have a little poke out of his hidey hole, but let Hampus work his space.
Lurky boy magic from Hampus.
Bomb spotted Yard.
Yeah, LNZ here just not with a whole lot to do. He draws attention, but Hampus has been spotted now as well. And unless he can hit a banger or two, this is looking like four on the trot here. Apex continues with this impact.
Yeah.
And Kyojin with range from the MP9. He wants to get his hands to that AK and to that position, right? So by dropping the smoke and taking a fight, he's done something outside of the box. And he's put NIP back down to just the pistols here. Now, space appears to be a problem in the gun round. Let's see if they can do what they did on the pistol and those lighter buys. They're able to take it, earn that respect. They're played right into Vitality's hands as, again, a different variation of the smoke wall is being lined on up. I just want to get yourself down secret here.
Yeah, they bloom in unison.
So as I was going to be tasked with dealing with that, dropping down the vent silently. As a smoke and a flash to try and delay, and you've just heard that smoke bloom below the feet. I don't think they're going secret though, are they? Towards main, popping top.
Yeah, and Kyojin will take the lobby space away from them. Because they haven't used Hut, he can use Hut. And oh, the silencer. It is starting to get so apparent the difference that rifle is making in terms of the way people die. Like, how often...
We definitely saw that yesterday in the G2 versus Ents game. I know it was down to the minutia right there.
And the Copenhagen Flames.
True. They were going for a lot more retakes. So that might change the status quo of Counter-Strike as of late. But device, mollied away. AWP will not be finding any targets just yet.
Just yet?
Just yet. I'm getting Swedish with it.
Yeah,
you've been practicing.
Thank you.
It is a nice sounding language, isn't it?
It is.
We don't know what they're saying, but it sounds like they're singing a bit of a song. Now this, I can't get over the start from Apex, right? I'm downplaying it right now because the score is 5-0 and it's map number one of the day, but he's owning them. He's currently 13 kills, five rounds in. Well, this is the sixth. He's found the opener here. He stalled out the round for the ninjas. They're stuck in no man's land as they line up some smokes again. He's just repositioned. Apex is living in a dreamland right now. He can do whatever he wants.
Hampus towards the Unbreakable. He's got past the only Bastion on Yard. It is Mr. Mathieu. Oh, and Device gets caught. The swing partnered up nicely. Linus gives NIP a chance, and it will hinge here on Hampus. Is Shox considering this so early? Oh. The answer was no, but Shox, just the reaction shot alone has put them into a very good stead to convert here.
Nice intuition. They're coming through main. Shox will have to deliver some more here. Dropping out some util. They're going to know where that came from. And on the peak, Shox is found by LNZ.
Okay, LNZ with three. This would be quite the clutch, but he has to get through Apex. 13 frags in
ace.
Five rounds, and he'll make it a 14th. The ace clutch. Tickets, please.
He has four opening kills so far.
Any more?
Let's see, because they're coming his way again. Okay. It's the pistols one more time.
Okay.
Molly only tickling Hampus here, and well, he's not a fan of getting tickled straight down into Zywoo. That's an opener, and the secret scamper is
going
to be followed on through. But if Apex pushes now, he'll be walking into three. Apex car crashes in their face again.
Wow, he's done well to get anything out of that. Rez just couldn't believe his eyes.
Through the smoke, he just appeared from nowhere. Well, they have a really good idea right now of where the T's were headed, and they continue towards this lower bomb site, the bomb on the back here of Plopsky. They've got three rifles now, a lot to work with.
Shox, oh, that's well played. He's actually caught one of the intimidating riflers. Rez will not be getting any more done. And Linus has only got the recovered Apex rifle, so no armor on that. Two fully equipped. LNZ, Plopsky, and Hampus, and Plopsky looking the wrong way. Masuta tested, and he passes with flying colors. A final head to Pluck, and it's Shox. When does this stop, Chad? When do NIP arrive?
Maybe never.
Good golly.
Miss Molly.
She the assistant to 007, Nikolai Dever-Reitz.
Oh, could be.
Agent. License to thrill.
License to chill right now. They need something here. Masuda, two on his plate, known to finish his meal.
Nice from Rez. That's exactly what you want to see. Starting strong.
Boy, Apex is tucked on in here. He can
just
hide.
Just in time.
Yeah, and the door's been... people have been flubbing that smoke a lot here at this event.
And that's a contribution from Hampus. They've got so much cash, Chad. I suspect we'll see a little bit more resistance out of them. And two topside here. Device's timing is so good. Just as they look away, a clean one out of the ninjas. It's Kyojin just to kick up a bit of a fuss. An AK upgrade's nice. And Shox could catch Rez. Solid for his second. And IP posting their first. Kyojin looking the wrong way.
They book. Bucks left in his bank balance. Take a look at a couple of the other members. We still have about 3.9 on Kyojin. Shox has 5.6 and Apex with 4.6. So it isn't going to take too long if NIP can string one or two more together here. CTs will have to question their buy, but Apex, well, he's not done with that yard presence. Masuda needs to be careful here again and pepper on up initially. They're walking through, and this time he finds the opener. Oh, this is going to land on his toes.
Has he got smoke? No.
Doesn't. Is it going to spread? Oh, imagine if he just
Dead man! He's just about found a safe corner. Nearly the 100 to woe. I've seen a couple of those.
Well, they're going to expect that to be clear, but it doesn't matter. They're heading towards top. Shox, he might get mollied out of position here as well.
Kyojin's got util.
Are they going to molly the CT Ven? It's a very common position.
It certainly is, but silent until now. Here comes the strike. Kyojin baits them in. Heads are turned. Start the strike. It's only the one. Rez again with impact, and Device follows up for his second contribution into the half. Both from Heaven's side. No info. And what is that aggression? Apex charging up, and now up to Masuda to clutch Device.
Light on. Well, they have been able to drop a couple of rifles across here. We'll buy up into them anyway. We've got a MP9 for Masuta, three M4s, and a Deagle for Zaiwu. There's no pep in the step of NIP. They're just going with this default spread, looking to find the picks. And there's another. Masuta gone down towards ramp. It seems quite simple right now. Occasionally, they're forcing the fight. This time, the fight coming to them. Remember Apex's start here, so if it was just him online, might need another teammate or two to start shipping on in here with some opening frags. Now with the number disadvantage, NIP can take their time. They're not in a rush. So much on that clock, still over that 1 minute mark. Bucket loads of utility. And we know that lobby aggression and lobby progressions is something that the CTs cannot afford to take back space, but they're just standing and waiting. Now top site is where Kyojin resides. Coming on in.
Oh, something in the feed of Daiwu's dig, and Kyojin can get nothing done. The reposition from Shox leads to another, and Daiwu's put another downrange as well. Hampus in trouble. Now, he is going to try and plant, but that's going to be rushed down by Apex.
You can almost taste it.
The final countdown.
Device is a bit of a one-man band out towards Yard. Just at his own pace here, allowed to work the AWP, allowed to look for a pick, and as we can see, there's currently nobody home. Main will be the first point of contact. And he just scope walked into Yard, straight in towards Warehouse, accelerating now. Hampus finds another onto Apex here, and that seemed a little bit
too
easy.
Look at Device's positioning. Like, I mean, they're good, and they're aware, and they have intuition, but okay, he's flashed off. They'll be looking for him, and he's spotted out now. The element of surprise is gone, and so is the majority of his health. But running out of players, Kyojin's looking the wrong way. Shox has put something. They need to clear him. Can't believe it. Kyojin actually does some damage to Plopsky as well on the descent. It's again Rez that kicks up a fuss.
And that probably something that won't be lasting for too much longer once we get those arenas back underway. Here we go towards the yard position. It's a hodgepodge by. Pistols at best at MP9 for Shox. They will be slinking down quite easily in towards that secret position with Hampus leading the charge. Three merry men behind him and LNZ up top of that silo there to cover off any potential flanks. If Apex does go for a maneuver like this, he is going to get his bottom spanked from the top floor.
LNZ, the contingency. Quick descent.
They're here in time.
Yeah, if he smokes the window off, that might buy time. Like, considerable time.
They should respect it, and they're going to hurt him fall off there.
Flying with the wallbang. crosshair placement. Yeah, Masuta could eat this.
He has a smoke as well here, Masuta. Curious to see if he wants to drop it to deny territory. There's still...
What, window or single?
Well, there's no confirmation that it is lower just yet. That probably aiding. But if he smokes it now, it'll give away his position here.
Smoke from the CTs did land there, but the bodies are all down and out. Apex was up to no good, but very late on his arrival here, and the entire squad has disappeared. Just looking to catch them on the way out now. See if he can make this one hurt, see if he can chip away at the finances of the Pyjama Ninjas. Were you ever a pyjama man, or have you always just been like a boxer?
When I was a kid, Jobby. Maybe.
Yeah, you had some PJs?
Yeah, I think up until probably the age of like 14.
Yeah? And like jammies? Yeah. Like full booties? Do you have the ones with the socks built in?
No, it's always weird to me having your feet covered when you sleep. I'm from a place where it's really hot.
Yeah, that is odd.
You don't want to have your feet covered.
But apparently, scientifically, there's some sort of benefit.
Okay.
I don't know. I just can't imagine. Hot feet, I think. Yeah? If I had socks on, I wouldn't have crummy feet.
Well, you'd have crummy socks.
Yeah, well, crummy socks is an easier to solve problem. I'm not treading toasty crumbs around the place.
Yeah, well, you could consider. I'm looking into one of these at the moment here as a robot vacuum.
A Roomba?
Yeah, get him out and about. Zooming around, picking up those crumbs.
I don't know. I don't want to let Skynet into my house.
With us at all times in our pockets right now. Speaking of crumbs, well, that's what these pistols are.
And if you haven't seen it, huge recommendation for Love, Death, and Robots, Zika Blue.
Is that in season 2?
I believe so. It's an episode about a pool cleaning robot.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
I recommend that one to a friend or an enemy. So, all the people that type cringe in Twitch chat, you can watch it too.
I love when words lose their definition.
Yeah, well, like cringe.
Yeah.
People just type cringe when they're cringe, but it's more.
It's something that they don't like, is what they mean. Hold up, this is a 1v1.
It is actually a 1v1.
It's a little bit cringe, isn't it, Alex?
It's so cringe, bro. Oh, it makes me so uncomfortable, and he gets them done.
Rest of them, as you mentioned, were on the USP, so that one's going to be a bit of a punch in the gut right here for NIP. That should be a conversion. It should have been their fifth, and now, well, they're going to be operating with, well, not a whole lot right here. In terms of rounds, that is. The guns are fine. I think 5.5, you know, you're going to be happy with that. This is their map choice, right? NIP opted to take things to Nuke, and we have seen this before, where they go for the top execute, and they like to leave a little bit of extra utility. Standard Molly, it's seeming everybody wants to throw that one these days towards the back of the site.
Yeah, and as a reaction to that, most CTs find themselves not playing it early. Oh, Kyojin. Not bad at all. Aggressive this time. Now, Shox, he's been up the rafters often and succeeding often. Oh, spotted out again. Rez saves their hide, albeit only for a moment. Man, advantage. Still plenty of time for Hampus to work his magic into a clutch of his own. They're both ready and waiting for you here. Oh, how is he supposed to isolate the jewels as it currently stands? He's not.
And LNZ down there with 4. But this has been great. I'm loving the fire in the belly.
You got medication for that.
Heartburn, right?
Yeah.
Well, Masuta has been caught out towards ramp a couple of times here. Either when they force this or he's pushed on through. And that smoke, it's starting to fade, so he will rescind. That's a bit more tempered with this. The molly will come down to a timing. Does he wait till he spots something or does he drop it early? And oh, he's going to get a face full of pistols now.
Well, that's enough of him. Well-placed incendiary will completely nullify the fast descent. I say that as a audible extinguish, and Plopsky already hanging out in hell.
Did they do that themselves? They must have mollied over towards the hell position, so extinguishing and forcing. So question marks now for Masuta.
He's going to be flashed, or unless Linus was considering it. The pause, perhaps for Plopsky.
Kyojin's looking from the site. It's a pretty good fight for Kyojin here, as long as he doesn't look away.
Oh, long range. That's something. Does lose device in the process, so falling apart a little here, despite the early chances.
Have to go B.
Yeah, and Apex is already tucked in. He's looking for more, Chad.
I know he's around. He's probably got a kill.
He's going to get himself another. Make it 3. That'd be a quick one. Overpass is next. You can see the Vito there in the top right. Overpass chosen by the French. Let's see how far this one can go. Rez has been equipped with the signature new flavor of the month in the form of the dual Berettas. Powerful in that hut position. Zipex giving us a tutorial just a couple of days ago.
Oh, that's a goose right there for Happers to copy. He has some nades. Might want to get those out of his hands before he falls on down. The beautiful HE.
Yeah, that's such good value out of that. Money well spent.
A lot of damage right here. That softened them up as they head down towards Secret, the lower side of things. Rez with this little tank is going to be creeping ever forward. Apex, how many more is he going to get here? Two angles of assault. Plopsky will get the kill and Apex falls.
I think his heal's just been spotted as well. They don't have numbers, but they spotted Shox. Now the low site completely and totally locked down. Shox struggles to find anything on that. So now a 4v3 into the retake. The doors have swung open and multiple angles of assault. Device coming in late. Well, not so late. Actually, he's been spotted out early. So now the distraction is in place. He's keeping two of them busy. And Kyojin, whose job was ramp. He does take Plopsky out. They're so low, so vulnerable. And a clean headshot from Rez.
Kit's on the railing. They might need to grab that.
Oh, Zywoo looking clutchy.
He got the kit.
Yeah, he's so low, though. Surely Zywoo could play this one out. Just a stray bullet and Hampus is down.
Knows he's off it.
Knows he's off it. Now the bullets. Oh, 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 he's run out of bullets.
Oh, Zywoo,
oh, the ninja,
no.
Zywoo. Crew. And he went through all 16 without finding that low HP on Hampus. Okay, great start. Now we see that French force, a scout exchange.
Tag on tag, both. Down to 32 points of health here. Plopsky's also taken a little bit of damage in the meantime. Zywoo's been lucky to get an AK-47, and the same for Shox here, who both have head armor, both have a bit of util. Sitting with a Galil, this is actually looking like a very decent buy for the French right now. Meanwhile, the Swedes, two M4s, Famous for LNZ, and oh, they're already almost out of nades here. Just one smoke to their name, three flashbangs, and that's a window smoke from Zywoo there. That one's going to go off towards the locker room. So Happers is not positioned there. That's a main smoke as well. So comboing is a, what to call them, the aim map smokes towards yard. It just levels the playing field a little bit.
Device actually choosing to stick around, and the pot shot's not far off. LNZ, just the one. Zywoo does take down Masuta in the process. So they knew the scout was ramp. And Shox descending Secret for space. Oh, not expecting Device to have stuck around. He strikes and finishes off what he started earlier.
Crazy regress. It means so much. The kill is great, but the info is huge.
Timing is everything from Shox. Looking for Device. Strikes. Site is open for business.
And it's
quite quick, actually. Like, it's a safe plant from ramp. Shox is not vulnerable either. And two rifles equipped for this retake. No kit in sight. Zywoo on site.
If he tucks in and hides here, that's not bad, because think about how much time they'll have to push on in. Shox might be able to combo with him here, but starting the crawl, Rez and Plopsky from the same position.
Okay, when does Zywoo choose to strike? Because this timing... Oh, if Rez does drop off, okay, no. Should have an advantage. Loud. Zywoo tames the spray nicely. Plopsky closing the gap. He does isolate the first of the duels, but no time for this.
Big problem now.
The sound cue alone has won the round for Shox. Would love to hit one into the head to finish. He does so nicely.
Limp, to say the least, is this force buy. They've done the best they can. Deagles are the primary choice. The scout for Device back towards yard. This time won't be having the equal exchange on the scout. Has to scamper on back. His Shox is buying a lot of respect here with his teammate Smokes. And there's the tag.
And that's the gap completely and totally exploited. Rez, good tracking.
There's three here at ramp. They're about to walk into the stack.
Suta not having any issues. They may not suspect Plopsky. They do clear him out. Device is going to struggle to find much more impact now on the scout.
Too lower already here.
Yeah, they're moving. They're very mobile, aren't they? They seem to be in all the right places, but not the quite the right connections. Zywoo to clear it out, not looking the right way on control, and only just maintains. That should be 13.
It either feels like Vitality, you know, that they got the luck of the gods on their side here. NIP can't catch a break, because some of these shots feel like they should be converting right there. Just non-lethal damage, but damage. Device wanting to scoop up a gun and looking to give this one a crack right now. 45 points of health, bomb halfway ticked, giving him about 20 seconds left to apply some more financial damage. We'll be ecoing in the next round to play here. And well, while we wait out these next few, I can tell everybody at home that we do have the B stream currently going on as well. We still have matches for the 8th to 5th positions, right? And the reason these games are being played, traditionally we don't do this, but it's an RMR event. All the positions.
Yeah, it looks like Death is having a great game over there. 17 frags from him early into the first half. Rez doesn't miss those, and Shocks, his casual stroll cancelled.
Well, they struggled last round, right? Rez hit the shot onto Shocks trying to cross into that secret position, and then they quickly made some trades over towards ramp. This time round, it is towards top, and wouldn't mind the fight here. Damage done through. Bobski shouldn't be long for this world. Does get taken out of the equation, but trades are still looking good. Just USPs. If they had something, right? If they had something a little bit spicier to work with here, they're also going to miss the timing because down the vent, the Frenchman hop. I think fakes and ladders is what I called it the other day.
I played some snakes and ladders the other day.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What, digitally?
No, me and my mum in the Wetherspoons.
Oh, wow.
And some snakes and ladders while we waited for our dinner.
Beef pie, I assume.
Gave up. Turns out.
Not a fun
game. Not much dopamine in that game.
These guns have been picked up, and they're going to test their luck here. Apex and Zywood posted to seal the deal. And that's pretty good. Yeah, he's putting up a fight indeed. Is there any fight left for the Swedes here, though? We will be moving on to Overpass. That's Device with some traction.
That's two opening deaths for Shocks as well. So advantage nip, Shadow, Apex, booked.
Three rounds in a row, they've had the number disadvantage now.
Oh, but Masuta has just completely solved the issue. It was a 3v5. And now, if anything, it favors Vitality. Masuta, two clicks, two heads gone. Rez making no secret of his presence.
They're just ready to swing that door open.
Yeah, on the double flash, they push on in. Nearly a pair, and Zywoo does strike. Plopsky's gone. Hampus from ramp, and Zywoo's actually ready to take that fight as well.
Having to worry about both positions, and well, Zywoo profits, and this might very well be the last round to play.
I thought we were about to see a gap closer. And it seems it's Kyojin just wants to close this one out, as does Masuta. NIP with nothing to show here on Nuke. And it's their pick, Chad. Vitality just one of those teams at the moment where if they're all, catch them on a good day. We've cast that Mirage game in particular up against Complexity in the groups where it just felt like they didn't even get a chance to play the game.
Yeah, if this Vitality goes deep in the major and like Kyojin comes online and Masuda's able to have this star form and the recruiting over there, XTAS and the entire Vitality camp, right, they need to get so much credit because the roster changes they've had, the names that they've brought in, and being able to time this, right? Everybody questioned whether taking Apex out of the roster was the right decision. Well, it's looking pretty good right now. Hampus, he gets a kill, but they know exactly where he is. The Molly's going to burn his toes. He has to fight, wow. Dies in the flames, and it's a 2v3 situation with a Famous and a Deagle.
Ooh, Device, look how aggressive he is being and profits. Masuta to Hunt so close to another there, and LNZ to...